Hello friends and welcome to my channel Organetic. Today we are going to look at the hallway of my subscriber Irina and check out how she organized it. If you want to take a closer look at something in particular from this video, make sure to visit Irina's Instagram. If you like videos about home organization, please subscribe to my channel and let's get started. First, let's take a look at the overall view of the hallway. It's spacious, light and neat. Its area is 13.5 meters, and there is one attribute to this hallway. It's completely made of IKEA kitchen. Basically, it has generic cabinet frames installed with wrinkled doors attached to them. The left part consists of ceiling-high kitchen cabinets, and the right part has above-the-fridge cabinets with basic drawers at the bottom right below. The only exception is the wall panel that was ordered separately to fit the available space. Wet shoes from the outside are hidden behind the corner on a doormat. The rest of the shoes are kept in the drawers. This is what they look like on the inside. This is seasonal footwear that the family is wearing right now. From right to left, first you can see husband's shoes, followed by Irina's shoes, and the last drawer is for the shoes that belong to their daughters. Shoes are stored vertically in the vegetable bins, which you've already seen in Irina's kitchen. This is what it looks like. Shoes can be stored in the compartments vertically to save space. There are two mirrors in this hallway. One of them is full length and it visually expands the space. The other mirror is small in size and is located right next to the front door. It's handy for checking your appearance right before going out. The open area here brings a welcoming touch to the space, and of course it's very convenient for putting shoes on, getting dressed and ready for the exit. The length of the sitting area is 1 meter 20 centimeters, so it can fit several people at once. The door rack is quite large and lays right at the entrance. Thanks to this, there is enough space for everyone, and the whole family and guests don't have to feel cramped. This hall cabinet is for Irina's husband's stuff. He is a professional wedding host and this is where he keeps his equipment. In their old apartment there was no room for it, so it was scattered all over the place. But now everything fits in this cabinet, which was ordered specifically for this purpose. The first drawer is where they keep keys, documents for the car, a dog's leash and even disposable shoe covers in case they forget something at home and don't feel like taking the shoes off to go and get it. And here is where you find shoe polish and a bunch of different sponges. The second drawer contains Irina's purses. She prefers small handbags, so they fit here really well. The third drawer is for umbrellas and the bottom drawer contains slippers for the guests. This is how the outerwear is stored. The upper section is for the adults' clothes and the below section is for the kids' clothes. This height is comfortable enough for the kids to reach on their own. Even though this is a kitchen frame, the owners have managed to add a closet rod to it. Take a look at how kids' beanies and gloves are stored here. Thanks to this hanging organizer with clear pockets, every item has its place. The adults' beanies and gloves are stored the same exact way, but in the upper section. The second cabinet is meant for the guests entirely. The outerwear can be put on top here. There is also a hat organizer. And below there is a small shoe rack. In addition, there is an extra rod in case some of the guests are children. This is what the cabinet looks like when there are no guests. It is used to store a stroller and children's scooters while the shoe rack is moved above. The very top section is meant for temporary clothes storage, for example, clothes that have been sorted out and is ready to be given away. The third cabinet is where Irina's husband's clothes are grouped into categories. The jackets are above and the suits are below. The space under the clothes is used rationally and nicely. This first organizer with compartments is with bow ties, this one is for handkerchiefs, and this one is for ties which are folded into rolls. Let's check out the area all the way at the top. Your jaw might draw at how well this hallway is planned. According to the good old tradition, the top section contains off-season outfits and footwear. Moreover, children's summer shoes are right above children's winter shoes. Women's summer shoes are placed above women's winter shoes, and men's summer shoes are above men's winter shoes respectively. But that's not all. What do you think is in the top cabinets above the drawers with purses? That's right, the off-season purses. The top cabinets here are the best place for storage because on one hand things stay in the area and if necessary they can be quickly pulled out, and on the other hand they are hidden away without taking up other valuable storage spaces. Irina calculated every inch of the hallway. This is where the cabinets for utility items are placed. There used to be the door to the kitchen here, but the owners decided to seal it. As a result, a niche formed that was perfect for these cabinets. They are 16 inches deep and also happen to be from our favorite Swedish store. These are Obhus frames with the kitchen cabinet doors, so Irina saved about $130, but it turned out to be more difficult to install. The legs were specially added to the base of the cabinets to hide the charging station with robot vacuum cleaner under them, which can be controlled with a remote. Let's look inside the cabinets. Floor cleaner, dish and laundry detergents, and other cleaning supplies and household chemicals are kept on the top shelf. And on the shelf above you can see clear storage containers with labels, so it's easy to find what you need. Just so you know, this is also where you can find a remote control and a nozzle for the vacuum cleaner. This shelf is for husband's tools. Everything is grouped into categories inside these convenient mini drawer units. They contain tape measures, scotch tape, scissors, and other useful household items. Nails are stored separately in this box with a blue handle. There is even a step stool in case you need to reach to the top shelf, and a plastic bag organizer that is hanging on the wall. On the left there is a steamer. The owners deliberately cut a hole for the access to the power socket to plug it right there. All you need to do is to turn it on and it's ready to steam. It's very handy when you need to iron shirts. The bathroom is nearby, so you can quickly pour some water for the steamer. Here is a little trick to unite separate areas of the cabinets into one. The doors didn't fit the frame, so this was the solution to make it work. Let's take another look at the area with the robot vacuum cleaner. The scales are hidden right next to it. Check out this cool idea on how to label the contents of the high cabinets. The labels are attached to the door here. As you can see, one shelf is for stuff for the car, and the other one is for kebabs, barbecue skewers, crates, and so on. This cabinet is completely empty. The space behind is put to use as well. This is where a mop and a scoop are hiding. And now I'd like to invite you to watch 22 genius organization ideas from Irina's kitchen. If you like this video, please show it to me by hitting the like button. Please subscribe to my channel if you're new. See you next week. Bye-bye.